Hi, today I'm going to tell you about a supplement for gut health that is so powerful that it actually cures IBS. I'm talking about a study where after 2 months on this supplement, literally 60% of the people in the trial no longer met criteria for irritable bowel syndrome. Crazy stuff. And the interesting thing is that this isn't a supplement that we commonly think about for gut health. We take it for brain health, we take it for arthritis pain, but we never think about the magic that it can work on our gastrointestinal tract. So today I'm going to change all that and tell you about this powerful supplement and why it should be part of your gut health regimen. I'm Dr. Dave Clayton. Let's get started. Well, let's start with what is gut health? I like to think about checking three boxes when it comes to gut health. One is intestinal motility. Is stuff going from top to bottom, front to back, working its way through my system? Or am I getting like that diarrhea and the constipation that comes with poor intestinal motility, either too fast or too slow? The next thing is the microbiome. We all know that we've got trillions of bacteria as part of our gastrointestinal tract, primarily in the colon, that help us digest food and keep our gut healthy. So we want to make sure that whatever we're taking enhances the ability of that microbiome to do its job. And the last thing I like to check is absorption. Are we able to digest nutrients that we're taking in the form of food or supplements? And, you know, the way to think about this one is that the more inflammation you have in the gut, the less able you are to absorb nutrients efficiently. And in severe cases where the gut is really working poorly, we actually start to see syndromes of malabsorption and malnutrition accordingly. So when I'm thinking about gut health, I want to check all three of these boxes, and I want to make sure that the supplement that we're taking is strong enough to affect all three of these. And what happens when your gut health isn't up to par and when you're not checking all three of these boxes? Well, the most common syndrome is called irritable bowel syndrome, or IBS, which affects up to 20% of Americans. And we get these symptoms of abdominal pain and cramping. We get constipation or diarrhea. We get the bloating, indigestion, heartburn, and just that sick feeling, that kind of lack of energy, that fatigue, the malaise that comes with having a poorly performing gastrointestinal tract. And then when we get into more severe gastrointestinal diseases, we really start to see that inflammation ramp up significantly. And that's like the inflammatory bowel disease, or IBD. Crohn's disease and ulcerative colitis are two of the most prevalent. Now, these affect up to 3 million Americans and more worldwide. And on top of a lot of those symptoms that we associate with IBS, we also get symptoms and signs related to severe inflammation of the gastrointestinal tract. And that can lead to bleeding and mucus, severe pain, fevers. And this can get so severe that we need super strong drugs like steroids or even anti-cancer, super strong anti-inflammatory medications. And you can get hospitalized, have surgeries. This gets bad. So anything that we take for our gut health, if it can really make an impact on the IBS symptoms or even the IBD symptoms, then we know we're on the right track. And the amazing thing is that there's a supplement that so many people take for different reasons that can really check a lot of these boxes when it comes to gut health, and that's curcumin. Curcumin is the active ingredient in the spice turmeric, and it's a common ingredient in curries and other types of food, and it's a strong anti-inflammatory and antioxidant that has widespread uses. Now, like I said before, commonly, we take this for joint pain because it is known to be a strong anti-inflammatory, and there's really good evidence there. Also, a lot of people take it for brain health, and there's good evidence to support that as well. But the surprising thing is how strong the evidence is for curcumin's role in keeping your gut healthy and actually having a significant impact on diseases like IBS and IBD that affect the gastrointestinal tract. And in fact, the data is so strong that I'm about to show you that I've started adding curcumin to my diet on a regular basis because of this. So let's start with curcumin's role as an anti-inflammatory. Well, here's a list of all of the inflammatory mediators that curcumin has an impact on, and it's a long list. I mean, there are literally over a dozen inflammatory mediators that curcumin is known to effectively modulate reducing that excess of inflammation in the body. And importantly, there's a number of inflammatory measures here that associate with either IBS or IBD. There's actually good evidence showing that low-grade inflammation plays a significant role in irritable bowel syndrome, and what we see is increases in tumor necrosis factor alpha, interleukin 1 beta, interleukin 6, and inflammatory bowel disease, which is that more severe form, has elevations in all of those, plus CRP, plus interleukin 2, plus erythrocyte sedimentation rate. So what we see is that curcumin as a very broad anti-inflammatory has effects on inflammatory mediators that are known to have a role in gut health. So if we want to take curcumin really seriously as a powerful tool in treating gut health, we want to see that it has an impact on the more severe forms of inflammation of the colon. And for this, we look to a trial, a pilot trial, of curcumin in patients who had severe ulcerative colitis or Crohn's disease. And like I said before, these are patients that take steroids on a regular basis, medications like prednisone, and medications that are stronger anti-inflammatories that we associate with, you know, other more severe syndromes. When we're looking for an effect on gut inflammation, we can look at these patients with inflammatory bowel disease as being the ones most in need of something that has a really powerful effect. And in this trial of 10 patients with either Crohn's disease or ulcerative colitis, the two most common forms of inflammatory bowel disease, what we see is some really significant data. Taking 500 milligrams three times a day of curcumin led to a significant reduction in symptoms, up to 44% reduction in symptoms associated with inflammatory bowel disease. And the inflammation markers, the biological indicators of the effect of the medication, were substantially reduced, up to 71% reduction in the inflammatory markers. And here's the crux of it, is 80% of the patients in this trial either reduced medications or eliminated medications just by adding curcumin 500 milligrams three times a day. So really compelling data showing us that not only is curcumin a really strong anti-inflammatory, possibly as strong as some of these other medications that are prescription, but that taking it actually has a significant impact on the gut to the point where your symptoms are improved, the biological markers of inflammation are improved, and you're getting rid of prescription medications. I mean, that is some serious evidence in support of curcumin as a tool for gut health. So we've checked the box on inflammation. We've got good data now that curcumin is a powerful anti-inflammatory for gut health. Well, now let's look at the intestinal microbiome. The best way to look at the function of the microbiome is to look at a test called breath hydrogen, which looks at the amount of hydrogen released when your microbiome, when those intestinal bacteria, get a hold of the food and are able to metabolize it and ferment those carbohydrates and give off hydrogen as a byproduct. So when we breathe out that hydrogen, what we're doing is we're giving an indication that the microbiome is doing what it's supposed to do and doing enough of it. And here we've got a really interesting trial where we took patients and we gave them two identical meals, a bowl of rice with curry, except for one of the bowls had 500 milligrams of turmeric as part of the curry, and the other bowl had same curry, but no turmeric, no curcumin. So same bowl of food, same amount of food, same ingredients, just with turmeric and without turmeric. And the equivalent was 500 milligrams of turmeric in these bowls. Now, when we look at the curve of breath hydrogen after these meals, you see a substantial increase in the amount of breath hydrogen. It's these black dots, the line that spikes way up after you take your first bite of the turmeric, and it stays high the whole way through, even hours after your meal. And what we see is that without the curcumin or the turmeric, it's kind of just a flat line pretty much, right? We don't see a huge increase in breath hydrogen, and it stays below the turmeric meal the whole time. And this is really interesting evidence showing us that the intestinal microbiome is triggered and stimulated and enhanced by eating the turmeric with the curcumin in it. So we've checked two boxes now, inflammation and intestinal microbiome. Let's just check the third box, which is intestinal transit time. So what we're looking at is a function of how long does it take food to go from one end of the small intestine to the other. And there's various ways of measuring this. And when we look at the same study with the two bowls of curry, and we look at how much time did it take for each bowl of curry to move through the small intestine, what we see is that without the turmeric and the curcumin, it took about 5 hours for the food to go from one end to the other. However, when it's the same bowl of food with the addition of just that turmeric, what we see is that about an hour of time is shaved off of that. So just a little bit more than 4 hours to get the same amount of food through the same amount of intestine. So really interesting that what we're doing is we're increasing the intestinal motility. We're actually moving stuff along faster and more efficiently. Number two is we're reducing that inflammation. And number three is we're enhancing the effectiveness of that microbiome. So curcumin checks the box on all three important measures of gut health. And it's why I think everybody should consider taking curcumin as part of your gut health regimen. So let's get back to this idea that curcumin is a treatment for IBS so powerful that it can lead to complete resolution of those symptoms. And here it is. Based on everything we've learned, it should be no surprise that curcumin, because it checks all three boxes of gut health, is super powerful when it comes to treating IBS. In fact, what we see here is that in a trial that included 200 patients with IBS treated with curcumin, that 60% of the patients who were treated with curcumin after 2 months had complete resolution of their symptoms to the point where they no longer met criteria for irritable bowel syndrome. So when they checked off those boxes saying, do you have intestinal bloating and diarrhea and constipation and all those things that add up to a diagnosis of IBS, they no longer met that criteria. And in fact, one patient in this trial was so amazed with the result that she said that after 9 years of kind of being locked in her house because she couldn't leave her toilet, that she now felt free again. And it wasn't because of some prescription medication, it was because of the natural supplement curcumin. And other data that came out of this trial, we saw a 70% reduction in symptoms. Super amazing. And for the patients that said they had normal bowel habits, the percentage of patients in this trial who said they went from having kind of abnormal bowel habits to normal bowel habits tripled. So 3 times more people at the end of 2 months said, hey, my bowels are normal. I don't have any problem with diarrhea, constipation, any of that stuff. So what we see is that 2 months on the curcumin was enough to lead to significant improvement in symptoms, often to the point where people were able to return to a normal life and say that they no longer met criteria for IBS. Isn't that awesome? So to wrap up, what we see is that curcumin checks all the boxes for gut health. We reduce inflammation, we enhance the microbiome, and we reduce inflammation and therefore improve absorption. And for patients that take curcumin for 2 months, we see a 60% reduction in the incidence of irritable bowel syndrome. And we see that for the same amount of time, patients with inflammatory bowel disease, 80% of them are able to reduce or eliminate a medication. So really compelling data, and you might be asking, what's the right dose? Well, really varies. I mean, when we look at the dose of curcumin that improved intestinal motility, that dose was as low as 8 milligrams of curcumin. For the IBS trial, we're looking at about 175 milligrams of curcumin. And then when we look at the inflammatory bowel disease, you're talking 500 milligrams 3 times a day. So a total of 1500 milligrams. So I think for me, 500 milligrams is kind of the right target dose to be taking once a day. And then if I want to get a stronger anti-inflammatory effect, then I'm thinking about taking higher doses more often. But I think 500 milligrams a day should cover most applications. And certainly there's ample evidence showing that that dose is effective in improving your gut, especially in those patients with irritable bowel syndrome. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I'll leave some links in the description to my website where you can get more information on this topic and others. And I'll leave a link for a curcumin supplement that you can shop for if you want to start adding this to your diet. So as always, I hope you enjoyed the video and I will see you next time. Thanks.